Dear students, today we will go ahead with a very interesting and important topic in the lower limb, that is femoral triangle. Femoral triangle is a triangular depression present in front of the thigh. So if we see in the upper one third of the thigh, the triangle which is present on the medial upper one third anteriorly in front is the femoral triangle. So if we see its outline, this is the triangle. So, the apex of the triangle is directed downwards. Base is formed by the inguinal ligament. And apex is formed by the meeting point of medial and lateral borders. So, this triangle is clinically quite important because big neurovascular bundle which is present in this femoral triangle, where we can see a vein, artery and nerve. The vein and artery are femoral vessels, femoral artery and vein, which are important axis for to reach the heart or to the reach the brain for interventional radiologist. So during any intervention to put a catheter, these two are often chosen blood vessels because they are quite larger blood vessels. So that is the reason this triangle is clinically quite important. And let's see the boundaries of femoral triangle. It has got a lateral boundary, medial boundary, base and apex. So here is the outline of the femoral triangle. Base is formed by the inguinal ligament. Apex is formed by the meeting point of medial and lateral borders. The lateral boundary is formed by the sartorius. To be specific, medial border of the sartorius. And medially, the medial border of adductor longus. So, part of the adductor longus forms the floor of the femoral triangle. So these are the boundaries of the femoral triangle. Let's see the floor. The floor, it is gutter shaped and it is made up of completely muscles. So from lateral to medial side, it is formed by iliacus. So the lateral most muscle is the iliacus. And next to the iliacus, the tendon of psoas major. Iliacus and psoas major, both are the flexors of the hip joint and both converge forming the iliopsoas tendon which gets inserted to the lesser trochanter of the femur. So, both are together forming the lateral side of the floor of femoral triangle. So, next is the pectineus and medial to the pectineus is adductor longus. So, these are the muscles forming the floor of femoral triangle. The roof of the femoral triangle. The roof is covered by the skin, superficial fascia and contents of it. Here is the cross section along the femoral triangle exposing the contents. And the other side we can see the femur here. This is femur and the muscles present in the floor, lateral to medial. So, which is lateral, which is medial in this cut section? So, the lateral one will be the artery here, arterial side. The medial side is, you can see the vein here and next to the vein, this is the femoral artery. Along with it, femoral vein. And most medially, we can see the lymph node, called as femoral lymph node. So, all this I will discuss little later. They are present in a sheath called as femoral sheath. The nerve, femoral nerve, is present outside the femoral sheath. This is the roof. So, the roof is formed by the skin, superficial fascia. So, deep to the superficial fascia is the deep fascia. In the thigh, we call it as fascia lata, and fascia lata contains an opening called as saphenous opening. where the great saphenous vein opens into the femoral vein via this saphenous opening. Then superficial fascia over the roof containing the superficial branches of femoral artery. So superficial fascia contains superficial branches of femoral artery, femoral vein. So we also see within the roof the upper part of great saphenous vein. Upper part of the great saphenous vein is also a structure present within the roof of femoral triangle. So what we see in the superficial, that is the structures forming the roof, are superficial inguinal lymph nodes. Writing here. And also it contains the femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. Femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve and the branches of ilioinguinal nerve. Just writing ilioinguinal nerve. So these are the structures present within the roof of femoral triangle. I'll just repeat again. It is formed by the skin, superficial fascia containing the superficial branches of femoral artery, upper part of the great saphenous vein, superficial inguinal lymph nodes, then the femoral branches of genitofemoral nerve and branches of ilioinguinal nerve. So these are the structures present within the superficial fascia. Then deep to the superficial fascia, the deep fascia modifies as fascia lata. Fascia lata shows a cribriform fascia, means a fascia containing openings, holes, called as cribriform fascia, exposing an opening called as saphenous opening. And as we know, the saphenous opening is present within the fascia lata. Even the upper part of the great saphenous vein present within the superficial fascia. And along with the upper part of the great saphenous vein, the tributaries of the great saphenous vein, which are superficial tributaries, present along with the branches of femoral artery. So all these are the structures forming the roof of the femoral triangle. And here it is a cross section. So we can see lateral to the medial side, we can see the iliacus forming the floor here. And this is psoas major. Iliacus and psoas major are together. And here is the pectineus. This is pectineus. This is adductor longus, which are the structures forming the floor of femoral triangle. Let's see the contents of femoral triangle. The main contents of the femoral triangle are femoral artery and its branches. This red one is the femoral artery and its branches, which are given off in the femoral triangle. Then femoral vein and its tributaries. Femoral nerve, which is present most laterally in the thigh. This is femoral nerve. And we have got some deep inguinal lymph nodes present medial to the femoral vein. And lateral cutaneous nerve of thigh, which is lateral most. And a part of it is present in the femoral triangle. So this is nerve of thigh. In addition to these structures, we also contain the femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. So which is along with the femoral artery. See here, this is femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. And also we have some fibrofatty tissue present within the triangle. So these are the contents of the triangle. You can see the beginning of the femoral artery is the mid-inguinal point, and it vertically runs downwards towards the apex. The artery passes forwards and medially. Lateral to the femoral vein, we can see in the beginning it lies lateral to the femoral vein. But we see at its apex, the artery becomes anterior and femoral vein goes towards the posterior side. The artery is anterior side. So that is the relationship between the femoral artery and femoral vein. Femoral artery gives three superficial branches. Superficial epigastric artery. So the branches of femoral artery are superficial epigastric artery, and along with that there are other arteries called as superficial circumflex iliac artery, then superficial external pudendal. All are superficial branches. Superficial external pudendal. So these three branches, they run along with the tributaries of the great saphenous vein, which are present within the superficial fascia. So that is about the superficial branches, and we can see a deep branch here. The deeper one is called profunda femoris artery. Profunda femoris artery is a largest branch of femoral artery, and if we see its origin, it arises on the lateral side and it spirals medially behind the femoral vessels. So further it divides into lateral circumflex. This is lateral one, and further this is the medial one. This is the profunda femoris artery. So femoral artery is the only artery which supplies all the structures in the thigh. So that is the reason the profunda femoris artery, as it is the largest branch, it goes to the posterior compartment to supply most of the structures in the posterior, that is hamstring compartment. So medial and lateral circumflex femoral artery supplies to the medial and lateral side, and the medial circumflex disappears passing between the psoas major and pectineus muscle, and the lateral circumflex femoral artery passes laterally between the anterior and the posterior division of femoral nerve. So the deep external pudendal artery pierces the fascia lata and passes medially behind the spermatic cord. So that is about the deep branches of the femoral artery. Next, about the femoral vein. Femoral vein accompanies the femoral artery. The vein is posterior to the femoral artery at its apex. I already said that vein goes posterior to the femoral artery at its apex. And on the medial, it lies medial to the femoral artery at its base. And it receives the great saphenous vein. You can see a tributary here. This is the great saphenous vein, which drains into the femoral vein. And apart from this great saphenous vein, there is profunda femoris vein also, which is along with the profunda femoris artery. And great saphenous vein gives off some tributaries, which are the superficial. So the veins are, tributaries of the great saphenous vein are superficial epigastric vein, superficial circumflex iliac vein, superficial external pudendal vein. The same name as the arteries, we have got veins which are present within the superficial fascia of the femoral triangle. Let's talk about this femoral nerve. Femoral nerve is the lateralmost content present in the femoral triangle, and these blood vessels, that is femoral artery and vein, they are present in a common sheath called as femoral sheath, whereas the nerve is outside the femoral sheath. And we can see the length of the nerve is very short. The length of the nerve is very short. It is only of 2.5 centimeters in length below the inguinal ligament. And it is present in the groove between the iliacus and psoas major muscle. So the floor is formed laterally by the iliacus and psoas major. So between these two muscles, the groove, within the groove, we have got this femoral nerve. And as we know, it is a very short trunk. Immediately it divides into anterior division and posterior division. The anterior division is here and the posterior is P, I have written. And they are encircling. You can see these two divisions are separated by an artery, which is the lateral circumflex femoral artery. branch of profunda femoris artery. So the anterior division gives off two cutaneous branches which are called as medial and intermediate cutaneous nerve. See, anteriorly the front of thigh is supplied by lateral cutaneous nerve, intermediate cutaneous nerve and medial cutaneous nerve. Lateral cutaneous nerve, it is a separate branch of lumbosacral plexus, whereas the intermediate and the medial cutaneous nerves, they are the branches of anterior division of femoral nerve. Whereas the posterior branch, that is the posterior division of the femoral nerve, it gives off only one cutaneous nerve, that is called as saphenous nerve. That is the posterior branch, it gives off muscular divisions which supply the muscles, and further it extends down along the lateral side of the artery. Next, about the lateral cutaneous nerve of thigh. So here is the lateral cutaneous nerve of thigh, which is present most laterally, supplies the lateral side of the thigh. Talking about this deep inguinal lymph nodes. Deep inguinal lymph nodes, they are usually three in number, upper, middle and lower. And they are present on the medial side within the femoral sheath. Sometimes you may find single lymph node instead of three. In that context, we call it as gland of Clocket or Rosenmüller's deep inguinal lymph node. Femoral sheath, it is a funnel shaped sheath enclosing the upper 3 to 4 centimeters of femoral vessels. So it is like funnel like here, enclosing the upper 3 to 4 centimeters. So this is the femoral sheath present in the upper part. And if you see, it is funnel like. Within the sheath, it is again divided into three compartments. Now what we are seeing is the anterior layer of the femoral sheath. Posterior to the vessels is the posterior layer of the femoral sheath. Anterior layer of the femoral sheath, it is the continuation of fascia transversalis of the abdomen. Whereas the posterior layer of the femoral sheath, it is the continuation of fascia iliaca, means which covers the iliacus muscle, called as fascia iliaca. So fascia iliaca and the fascia transversalis forms the continuation, and further below the femoral sheath continues with the outer layer of these great vessels. So the outer layer of the great vessels is tunica adventitia. So it blends with the tunica adventitia of this femoral artery and vein. So intermediate compartment contains femoral vein here, and the medial most compartment, it almost empty, and it contains the femoral lymph nodes. So it is filled with the loose areolar tissue and contains one or two femoral or three femoral lymph nodes. And this part, this is the medial compartment, is called as femoral canal. It is called as femoral canal, and clinically this femoral canal is very important, will provide the dead space for this femoral vein to dilate during venous return. That is the normal action actually. But because this is a potential space, okay, if there is a weaker abdomen, there is a chance of protruding the contents, abdominal contents, into this femoral canal, which is called as femoral hernia. So, let's talk about this femoral hernia now. Femoral hernia is a very important clinical aspect associated with this femoral triangle. This hernia, it is located below and lateral to the pubic tubercle. So, when the person coughs or when person strains, he can feel the protrusion of this abdominal contents into this femoral canal. So, that is called as femoral hernia. So, the passage through which the femoral hernia is entered into the thigh is, it is through the ring. So this canal is guarded by this ring, the upper boundary, it is the femoral ring through which the abdominal contents protrude into the femoral canal. Further, what happens, it protrudes into, and later it may cause strangulations. So the cause of the strangulation, it is because of unyielding nature of this femoral ring. So, we know this femoral ring, which is the upper margin of this femoral canal. So, if you see this canal, it is funnel-like like this. So, the medially, this is the femoral ring. So, what you are seeing, this is the femoral ring. And these are the other compartments where artery and veins is present. So, here is the lymph node of Clocket. So this is that lymph node. So let's talk about the boundaries of femoral ring. Anteriorly, it is formed by the inguinal ligament, and posteriorly it is formed by the, we can see here, this is the pectineus present on the posterior side. So the fascia covering the pectineus will form the posterior boundary, and medially this crescentric one is formed by the lacunar ligament, and laterally you can see this septa, we can see this septa separating it from the vein, that is the middle compartment, that is the anteroposterior septa. So that this septa forms the lateral boundary. So let's see again, anteriorly inguinal ligament, posteriorly the fascia covering the pectineus, medially the lacunar ligament, and laterally it is by the septa. So the direction of the hernia, it is downwards, forwards and upwards. So the hernia will protrude downwards, then goes forwards and again upwards like letter J. And during the manual reduction of the femoral hernia, the surgeon reverses the order. Means it pushes again downwards, then it goes towards the backwards and upwards. So it is the reverse of the movement down. This intestinal obstruction, it may cause venous congestion followed by arterial occlusion also. So the intestinal loop devoids of the blood supply because of the congestion and occlusion of the artery, leading to strangulation of the hernia. So if it is prolonged without any treatment, it may lead to the strangulation. So they will have a referred pain towards the umbilicus if there is any femoral hernia. So this is all about the femoral sheath, femoral hernia and clinical aspects, and we completed the femoral triangle with its boundaries, contents and some important applied aspects. So that's all about the femoral triangle. Thank you.